World Sports Arena, we pick up with second round action in a bantamweight fight. The opponents, Joe Oriwa of Nigeria against Hector Lopez under the banner of Mexico. Hector being the lad who was raised in Los Angeles, only recently went to Mexico City, filed for citizenship papers, and is fighting under the banner of Mexico. There is Oriwa. He is a terrific young fighter, as all the Nigerian fighters have been. But there is Hector Lopez. Both men proficient in earlier victories, and in the first round, sparkling boxing. Perhaps the edge went to Lopez, who is doing very well indeed. But it could have been called an even round. Action from the first bell to the closing bell of that first round. And they're right back at it now. Each man knows how to box. Good right gotten in by Oriwa. And another one. The Nigerians suddenly explode. We've learned that about them in previous rounds. Now they are all built the same way. Compact. And they are all purposeful in their punching. For a while, they may look like they're getting outpointed, and then suddenly the explosion. Lopez has a beautiful flicking left, but in this round, that's the third right in this round the Nigerian has caught Lopez with. So Lopez is proving vulnerable in this round to the Nigerian's right, but look at Lopez come back. This is the way these fighters have been, especially in the lower weight classifications. Fighters from foreign lands, some great teams, Nigeria, Mexico, Canada, beautifully coached, Italy, of course, South Korea, and all of the African nations, for that matter, have come on so tremendous influx of great fighters from foreign countries. A whole new look in amateur boxing around the world. Lopez uses his left beautifully. Caution. Referee is Novacek of Yugoslavia. Five judges scoring at ringside. Mandatory headgear. Must hit with the white portion of the glove. 20-point must scoring system per round. And the judges come from Chile, Brazil, Chinese Taipei, Pakistan, and the Philippine Islands. Second round action. And we're down to 30 seconds left in the round, and the boxing is terrific. And look at Lopez come on at the end of the round. Scoring this fight is not going to be easy for these judges. The crowd reacting to it, as you can hear. Lopez, a tireless puncher. And the Nigerian fighter, Oriwa, trying to push him off, not able to do so. What a round, what action, and we'll be back.
My hot dog has a first name, it's O-S-C-A-R. My hot dog has a second name, it's M-A-Y-E-R. That's Oscar Gawfire, and you see, it's the only one for me.
Oscar Mayer roasted hot dogs made with only select cuts of beef and pork and no fillers for a hot dog as honest and wholesome as kids themselves.
No matter what unexpected problem should arise, Transamerica Property, Casualty, and Life Insurance can be there to protect you.
Hey, you big ape! Who's gonna pay for this mess?
Transamerica. Insurance, finance, manufacturing, transportation, innovation. The power of the pyramid is working for you. Memories don't have to be a thing of the past.
can be anywhere.
And I'll be seeing you.
I mortgaged my house to get my first tug. Believe me, the Genie T needed plenty of work.
Good night, Skipper.
Today, I own two others just like her. Because we give our customers a good, honest pull for the money, and that pays off. People who make Meisterbrow work the same way. These days, I can pick any beer I want. This tastes as good as Budweiser, and it doesn't cost as much. Gentlemen, the drinking lamp is lit.
Meisterbrow tastes as good as Budweiser at a better price.
Action kicks off September 8th at 9 p.m. with a barn burner as Heisman candidate Doug Flutie and Boston College battle Ray Perkins' Alabama Crimson Tide. On the 15th, national powers collide as the Oklahoma Sooners square off against the mighty Pitt Panthers. And on the 29th, the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame take tradition and toughness to the field when they meet Missouri, the class of 84. CFA College Football, only on ABC.
Sports Arena, round three, bantamweight fight, Oriwa of Nigeria and Lopez of Mexico. And what a fight this has been. We have had continuous action since the very start of the fight, no let up. The second round was a dilly. This is a fight that can go either way. Although Lopez fought brilliantly the final minute of the second round. Early in the second round, Oriwa was dominating with his right. Lopez proving to be vulnerable with it. But then on came Lopez. And Lopez threw more punches. He seems utterly tireless in the manner of Mexican fighters. Although this lad, as I've mentioned, was raised in Los Angeles. There's that right that he's vulnerable to. Oriwa scored well with it. But it's hard to put the Mexican fighters down. Another strong right by Oriwa. Again, I say, a very difficult fight to judge. We are more than halfway through the round. There's that right again. Lopez not scoring nearly as well thus far in this round as he did in the prior two. Caution to Lopez from referee Novacek. It's a good round for Oriwa. Good round. Good left there by Oriwa. You saw it. Lopez now seeking to come on in the very late going. We're at 35 seconds to go and counting down. This has been the Lopez pattern, a burst, a flurry, the end of each of the prior two rounds. But not sustaining it this time. Oriwa in total command in this round. But again, scoring is going to be very interesting because there were two other rounds in this fight. And we are counting down to the end of the battle. This is it.
Ladies and gentlemen,
now
the winner
decision
on points, 4-1, in the blue corner, Hector Lopez.
Hector Lopez
representing
gets the
Mexico.
On the basis of the first two rounds, although Oriwa dominated the third and final round, Lopez had apparently won the first two rounds and Hector Lopez, a Los Angelino fighting under the banner of Mexico, is awarded a 4-1 decision. In slow motion, you see some of the action again. And that was Oriwa in the final round when he did dominate. But they fight three rounds, and there are the scores. Red corner in the left, blue corner score on the right. Pakistani scored it for the Nigerian fighter. Philippine Island scored it even, but gave the edge to Lopez. And the other three judges gave the edge, as you can see, to Hector Lopez. A close, brilliantly fought fight here in the boxing venue.
Howard, thank you. I hope you saw earlier this morning the first ever women's marathon of these Olympic Games. America's Joan Benoit winning that. And of course, the women's marathon ran through some glorious coastal territory of Los Angeles, through Marina Del Rey, Venice Beach, and Santa Monica. Each town with its own personality, each beach attracting its own crowd. Well, one of the most interesting is Venice Beach. And who else but our Hughes Red will take us down there now to see what's there.
Venice, California is the Greenwich Village of Los Angeles, which is to say it's a state of mind as much as a mailing address, and a pretty altered state of mind too. This is Exhibition City, where you let it all hang out, flaunt it if you've got it, and even if you don't. Strutting your stuff out here is best done on ball bearings. This guy looks like he belongs to the Baby Blue Regiment of the French Foreign Legion, but with any luck at all, he'll never hear a shot fired in anger. If you don't move on the boardwalk, your act really has to say something. This guy is saying, look, I'm not moving. The young ladies are making other kinds of statements. Somebody's watching me, and I have no privacy. This lady did not fall into a vat of hydrochloric acid. She's just trying to be with it, ahead of everybody else. The boys and girls at Muscle Beach in Venice certainly are with it, if it's deltoids and pectorals you're looking for. They must sell baby oil by the gallon out here. A trend in this ding-a-ling village lasts about 15 minutes, so by the time you've seen this, they'll probably be doing something entirely different along the boardwalk. Let's hope so, anyway. But meanwhile, let the good times roll.